Welcome to the students. I'm Chef Preeti Sinhal, Assistant Professor at AISSMS CHMCT College of Pune, Shivaji Nagar. I teach food production as a subject in the college. I have already shared 3 videos with you guys. I hope you all are watching that.
This is the new video, which has the topic is a sweetener. Objective of this chapter is types of sweetener we will come to know. The stages in sugar cooking, different stages, and what is the catering use of the sugar that we are going to learn. So what is sweetener? Sweetener which gives you a sweet taste, which add a sweetness to the food. That is a sweetener. Okay. So the first is sugar. Sugar is either produced from sugarcane or beetroot. It is 99.9% pure sucrose. Sucrose is a term used while means refined cane or beet sugar. Sugar is a class of edible crystalline substances, mainly sucrose, glucose, and fructose. It is a basic food carbohydrate, primarily comes from sugarcane or sugar beet. It also appears in fruit, honey, sorghum, then sugar, maple syrup, and in many other sources. In excessive consumption of sugar has been associated with increased incidence of type 2 diabetes also, obesity, and tooth decay also. Now, chemically speaking, there are 3 types of sugar. Simple sugar, compound sugar, and invert sugar. Simple sugar includes glucose of dextrose and fructose or galactose. These are called as monosaccharides. Compound sugar that includes sucrose, lactose, and maltose. These are called as disaccharides. Invert sugar. This is a mixture of glucose and fructose which can be made by heating a sucrose solution with an acid. Types of sugar. First is granulated or grain sugar. The size of the crystals are controlled during the refining process. The regular granulated sugar is made for fine grains. That is used for generally F&B manufacturing. That we use regularly on our table, on our regular food. Next is caster sugar. That is fine granulated sugar. The size being controlled during refining process. It is used in biscuits and cakes prepared by creaming method. So mostly baking and confectionery it is used for. It is known as confectioner's sugar also. Pulverized or powder sugar. Next is grain sugar which is pulverized to get a coarse powder is called as powder sugar. We'll move to next, which is icing sugar. It is known as confectioner's sugar. It is obtained by passing pulverized sugar through silk sieves. It controls small amount of cornstarch, around approximately 3%, which prevents caking of sugar and used for cake decoration also. Next is brown sugar, as you can see with the color. It is a cane or beet sugar in which the refining process has not been completed. It is made up of sugar crystals surrounded by molasses and some amount of moisture. It is brown in color and contains 85 to 90% sucrose and a small amount of invert sugar. The characteristics, flavor, and color of brown sugar is due to caramel and other substances present in the natural sugar syrup before refining. Next is Demerara sugar. It is a moist sugar made up of light yellowish crystals and has a rich flavor. Again, this color is due to the compound saccharine present in the cane sugar, cane syrup, I'm sorry. Sugar syrups are moisture retaining agents in baked product and includes molasses, malt syrup, invert sugar, honey, then golden syrup and liquid glucose. Now there are sugar syrups which are natural sweeteners. Under that, the first one is black tracker. It is a British generic name for any syrup made during the refining of sugarcane. Therefore, if I say theoretically treacle, black treacle, molasses, golden syrup or blackstrap are all syrups. So first one is black treacle. It is made from the syrup obtained from later boilings and is about 55% sucrose. It is partially inverted and filtered molasses. Black treacle has a slightly burnt caramel flavor that is a bit stronger than that of a medium molasses. Next is molasses. Molasses is concentrated sugarcane juice. Sulfured molasses is a byproduct of sugar refining. It is the product that remains after most of the sugar is extracted from cane juice. Unsulfured molasses is not a byproduct but a specially manufactured sugar product. It has a less bitter taste than sulfured molasses. It contains large amount of sucrose and other sugars, including invert sugar. It also contains acid, moisture, and other constituents that give it its flavor and color. Next is golden syrup, which also comes under natural sweetener under sugar syrups. This is again byproduct of sugar refining. When the syrup after many boiling no longer yields crystals, the syrup is filtered and concentrated. As the name is given, golden syrup, it is an amber in color. It is a mixture of sucrose, invert sugar and around 15-18% of water with some natural substances responsible for its flavor. Golden syrup can also be manufactured by inverting boiling sugar and water with a weak acid. The acid is neutralized and the syrup is then colored and concentrated. It is essential for preparation of ginger goods or biscuits. It gives a nice moistness and a different flavor. Maple syrup. We all know we love to put it on our pancakes. So how it has been made? Maple syrup is a sweetener made from the sap of maple trees. In Canada and in the US, it is most often eaten with waffles and pancakes. It is sometimes used as an ingredient in baking also. The making of candies, preparing desserts or as a sugar source and flavoring agent in making beer also it is used for. It gives a nice distinctive flavor and moistness to the product. Next is honey. Very common kind of a sugar syrup which we regularly use in our house, in our homes. So honey is a sweet and viscous fluid produced by honeybees and some other species and derived from the nectar of flower. It is one of the first sugar known to man. It is a natural invert sugar containing essential oils and aromatic substances which are responsible for flavor of honey. It contains around 75% of invert sugar and 15-20% of water. Honey mainly consists of invert sugar which has been produced by the enzymes produced by the bee. The main uses of honey are in cooking, baking, as a spread on bread and as an addition to various beverages such as tea, as a sweetener in commercial beverages. Nowadays, people have become very, very health conscious. So it is better to use natural sweetener. So in like green tea or lemon teas or different kind of these kind of teas. In that also people uses honey, which is good for your health instead of using the white sugar. Next is golden syrup or glucose syrup and corn syrup, also known as confectioner's glucose, is a syrup made from the hydrolysis of starch. Maize, corn is commonly used as a source of the starch in the US, in which case the syrup is also called as corn syrup. But glucose syrup is also made from potatoes and wheat, and less often from barley, rice or cassava. Glucose syrup containing over 90% glucose is used in industrial fermentation. Corn syrup is used in foods to soften texture, add volume, prevent crystallization of sugar and enhances flavor. Nowadays, a lot of chefs uses it in the bakery product. Like if you want to make a cake, in cake batters, in your ganaches, in your chocolate mixes, glucose are used because it does not crystallize and it keep the, it increases the shelf life, it keep the product moist. Next is jaggery. We all know we use this since years or ages. We are using jaggery in our houses. Manufacturers sometimes prepare raw sugar as loaves rather than as a crystalline powder by pouring sugar and molasses together into molds and allowing the mixture to dry. This results in sugar cakes or loaves called jaggery or gur in India. Nowadays, again, people are using, instead of white sugar, more of jaggery. It has a lot of health benefit. It is very, very iron-rich product, which gives nutrients. Now, after this kind of sugars, we'll move to the artificial sweeteners. There are many artificial sweeteners available in the market. These are material often replace sugar in manufactured food, sometimes because of the high cost of the sugar, but often because they can easily tolerate it by diabetic patients. Some sugar substitute are natural, some are synthetic. So those are not natural, are in general referred as artificial sweeteners. They also have a very distinct advantage for Weight Watchers, and that they have a little or no caloric value to the diet. Artificial sweetener, under that, the first one is sorbitol. It is a natural product occurring in some fruits, for an example, plums and apricot. It is, however, metabolized in the same way as sugar and therefore has a calorific value, but is apparently tolerated by most diabetic patients. And it is mostly used in jams, marmalade, extra for such people. Saccharin. It is the most widely used material since it is synthetically produced and has sweetness 300 times to 500 times greater than sucrose. It is not metabolized by the body and consequently has no food value. So it is very, very suitable for diabetic foods. Next, we will move to cyclamate. Another synthetic product, it is again 30 to 50 times sweeter than sucrose, which is known as our regular table sugar, the grain sugar, making it the least potent of the commercially used artificial sweetener. It is often used with other artificial sweetener, especially saccharin. It was preferred principally because it has little or no aftertaste, as in the same form of saccharin, because it was a heat stable in processing, unlike saccharin, which is not heat stable. Now we will move to different stages of cooking of sugar. When we start cooking sugar, there are two ways to cook a sugar. Either it can be a wet method or a dry method. If we are cooking the sugar by dry method, there is no water to be added into that. If we are cooking by wet method, a little water to just wet the sugar has been added. So under that, there are many stages. It's a chart over here. We'll go one by one with the pictures. So first one is a thread stage. It is obtained at 110 degrees centigrade. Sugar concentration 80%. At this relatively low temperature, there is still a lot of water left in the syrup. And when you drop a little bit of the syrup into cold water to cool, it forms a liquid thread that will not boil up. Next stage after that is soft ball stage, which is at immediately 112 degrees centigrade. Again, the sugar concentration increases to 85%. At this temperature, sugar syrup dropped into cold water will form a soft, flexible ball. This is how we check the different stages of ball by putting them into the water. This is one method of doing that. If you remove the ball from water, it will flatten like a pancake after a few moments in our hand. That is why it is known as soft ball stage. The next is firm ball stage, which is over here. At 118 degrees centigrade, sugar concentration now increases more, which is 87%. When we drop a little bit of this syrup in cold water, it will form a firm ball, one that won't flatten when you take it out of the water, but remains malleable and will flatten when squeezed. Next is hard ball stage, which is this. The temperature is now 121 degrees centigrade. Sugar concentration has reached to 92%. At this stage, the syrup will form thick, ropey thread as it drips from the spoon. The sugar concentration is rather high, which means there is less and less moisture in the sugar syrup. When it is dropped into cold water, it will form a hard ball. If you take a ball out of the water, it won't flatten at all. The ball will be hard, but you still can change its shape by squashing it. Next is, which is soft crack stage. Now the temperature has reached to 132 degrees centigrade. Sugar concentration is 95%. As the syrup reached soft crack stage, the bubble on top will become smaller, thicker and closer together. At this stage, the moisture content is very, very low. When you drop a bit of a syrup into cold water, it will solidify into threads that and remove into the from the water are flexible but not brittle. They will bend slightly before breaking it. Next stage is hard crack stage, which we will obtain at 148 degrees centigrade. Now sugar concentration is very high, which is 99%. The hard crack stage is the highest temperature you are likely to see. Basically, it is specified in a candy recipe. Over here, it becomes a candy. At these temperatures, there is almost no water left in the syrup. When we drop a little bit of syrup in cold water, it will form hard, brittle thread that break when bent. So these are the different stages of sugar when we cook it. The caramel is also obtained, which is at 160 degrees centigrade, which is a coloring agent. And after that, there is a blackjack, which is absolutely blackjack. That is again another coloring agent, and it is obtained at temperature 170 degrees centigrade and above. Now we'll move to catering uses of sugar. What are the different catering sugars uses are there? It softens gluten in flour to make baked product more tender to eat and lighter in texture. It caramelizes due to oven heat and contributes a beautiful crust color, which we see in our breads and our cookies, all the bakery and confectioneries. Caster sugar, due to its fine grains, entraps air cells during creaming method. Creaming method is used when we are making cakes or when we are making cookies. In creaming method, we cream the fat and the sugar together to make it a light and airy. So because of that, fine grain, it entraps the air cell very nicely. So it becomes very light and foamy. This property imparts tenderness in the product. Now, sugar being hygroscopic in nature, hygroscopic matlab, which means which holds the water, retain moisture in cakes and increase the shelf life of a product. It does not let it dry faster. We'll move to the next. Some more catering uses. It act as a preservative in jam, jellies and marmalades. It act as an anti-coagulating agent while making custard. Coagulates matlab, it does not let it set. Coagulates. It act as an activator. It helps yeast to grow fast. When we are giving sugar act as a food to the yeast, so it activates the yeast activity and providing readily available source of nourishment. It act as a food. It is a main ingredient for cake decorating like sugar paste, royal icing, etc. These are some of the uses over here in different baking desserts. Over here on the bread, it gives a nice beautiful color. Over here, the yeast has been given food in the form of sugar. This is a pulled sugar. Over here, glazes in the form of sugar has been given to the dessert or food, anything we can say. Thank you so much, everyone. Please do watch this video. And if you don't understand anything, please drop a mail on my mail email ID, which I will be sharing on YouTube. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. ASSME student, whoever will be attending this video or watching this video, you have to attend the link of the questionnaire. Thank you so much.